Greetings from Olympia. I'm your state senator, Linda Evans Parlette, still with a scratchy voice, and I apologize for that. It's an honor to represent you. We are now in the third week of the legislative session, and some of the key things that have happened this week have to do with the budget. On Monday, the House of Representatives voted on a bill to partially address the shortfall in the current state operating budget. Last November, the forecast projected about a $1.1 billion deficit in the 2009-11 biennial budget, which ends this year on June 30th. In December of last year, during the lame duck session, the legislature voted to cut approximately $588 million out of the budget. Well, the budget is still more than half a billion dollars in the red, and it has to be balanced by June 30th of this year. So this week, the House bill reduced expenditures by around $222 million and made some transfers of about $125 million from other accounts. That still leaves a big gap of several hundred million dollars that has to be resolved before June 30th. The Republicans in the House of Representatives proposed a different approach. They believe that the measure relied too heavily on retroactive cuts to education. But unfortunately, the bill passed along straight party lines, and now it is over here in the Senate for us to vote on it. However, in the Senate, things are proceeding a little bit differently. Right now, there are ongoing discussions between budget leaders on both sides of the aisle about the budget. There hasn't been any budget legislation proposed yet, but hopefully it will be done in a bipartisan way. Governor Gregoire has said the legislature must pass a supplemental budget by February 4th, or she will enact more across-the-board cuts. That's a good impetus to get this job done. Time is short, because next week, February is here. Now, some may want to wait until the next revenue forecast in March comes out, but that's taking a huge risk because we really do have to balance this budget for this fiscal year by June 30th. I want to fill you in on a state capital budget project in Olympia. I don't know if you've heard about it at home, but it has really hit the press in our state capital newspapers. There's a building called the Washington State Data Center Building. This is a project that has been really in the works since the 1990s. Construction on this building began in August of 2009, and it's about a $255 million project. The goal was to put all of the state's information services in one building. Well, last week, we learned that less than 10% of that building may be necessary. A consultant recently issued a report on the project and found that technology has improved so much that allows for more data storage in a smaller space that this building really doesn't have to be totally utilized. This is really unfortunate because you know we've got these data centers in Eastern Washington, and some of the data certainly could have been used and stored there. This new building is 50,000 square feet. And the state may only need 4,000 square feet of that. A more conservative estimate is that perhaps 25% is needed. The state says it can lease this space out, but really that is beside the point. In these tight economic times, there is a real need to make sure our tax dollars are being spent very wisely. Well, some lawmakers have called for halting the project immediately and re-examining the need. Time will tell on what happens there. Finally, I want to update you if you're interested in receiving the government guide this year, because I will be sending it out by email instead of during or through the mail because of these budget cuts. So for those of you who don't know, my email address is linda.parlette@leg.wa.gov. Feel free also to call my office at 360-786-7622, and we can get one of these government guides to you. Thank you for the feedback you've given me so far this session. I've heard from many of you. It allows me to represent you better in the Washington State Senate. Until next week, when I hope I have my voice back, thank you for the honor of representing you.